Namaskar students, hope you are all doing well. Today we are going to do English language class. So take out your English language class work copy and give the heading creative writing. In creative writing we are going to do letter writing today. Now students, we have two kinds of letter writing. One is informal letter and the other one is formal letter. Today we are going to do informal letter. First let us discuss about the format of the informal letter. Okay, so you are going to write the format in your copy also. First let me discuss, and after you have understood then you write it down. Okay, see, this is the format of the informal letter. An informal letter has 5 main points. Heading includes sender's address. Mention full address with pin code. Now in full address, your address, it can be 2-line, it can be 3-line. See, here I have written the address 3B Model Town, New Delhi 110088. Your address can be 3-line also. It may be from Kolkata, Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, any place. Okay, now comes the date. So leave 1 line and then give date. Here I have given the date 21/7/20. In this manner you are going to write. Again leave 1 line and then give or write the opening salutation, that is dear, and it is followed by the person's name to whom you were writing, and then give a comma. Clear? An informal letter can be addressed to different person, like your parents or a friend or a cousin or grandmother or grandfather or any other relatives. So again give a line gap and we begin the body of the letter. We start informal letter with warm, light-hearted pleasantries like how have you been, how are you, hope you are well, hope everything is fine there, hope you and your family are fine, what's been happening lately with you, thanks for your letter, it was great to hear from you, I hope this letter finds you in best of spirits, and many more as you feel like writing. This becomes your introduction, starting. Then come the part where you discuss about the topic you are going to write about. This is known as main content. Here you give details like what events occurred, what emotions you have felt, and about your plans you have for future. Be relevant and picturesque, obviously. Now comes the final paragraph, that is conclusion. Here you end the letter on a positive note that will leave your friend with positive feelings. Encourage your friend with to write back like hope to hear from you soon or please write back, etc. All these 3 paragraphs are the main content or body. Then again leave 1 line and write the closing salutation, yours lovingly, comma, and then in the next line write the sender's name. This is the last portion. So in this way you write an informal letter. Remember one thing, that you are going to write the letter in left alignment, that is throughout the letter, give paragraphs or whatever, you have to follow left side. Okay, now let's go to the exercise. Write down, write a letter to your friend telling him or her about your visit to a hill station. You have to write this in your English language classwork copy. I will read out a letter as an example for your help. Please listen carefully. Write a letter to your friend telling him or her about your visit to a hill station. So how you are going to start, that already I have shown in the previous slide, this way. Okay, now I am going to read out the letter. Dear Anantajit, I received your letter. Sorry for being so late to reply. I was away from home for few days. In fact, I went to Leh Ladakh with my family. I just returned yesterday. Let me fill you up with the details of my trip. The most important part of the trip was that I got to experience snowfall. We had just arrived in Leh when the sky started to darken, and before we knew it, snowflakes were floating in the air and falling down on us. I stuck out my tongue to have a taste. I felt delighted with these light, airy things covering us in a thin coat of white. It fell on road slowly, turning black or brown into white. It looked like a long white carpet waiting for us to trod on it. I was ecstatic. We picked up some, rolled them into balls, and pelted each other with snowballs. Before long, other people on the streets were also doing same. In other words, we were having a blast. It seemed like a snowball carnival. It was one of the most beautiful sights or experience I ever had. It was freezing cold there. Later on, we saw many snow-capped mountains without much flora or fauna, but its beauty was breathtaking. Hope you will also get an essence of this experience. Write to me soon with full of your news. Yours lovingly, Nitya. Students, I wrote this in my own way. You make your own and write in your English language classwork copy on the same topic. Wait for the next class. Till then, students, Namah Shivaya.